guys. I got plans for this band that don't include it doing no crash and burn. At least not yet.
Why, you punk. You traitor.
See that man, you're crazy. That's why I'm getting out of here. Going against a guy with a gun in his hand. You are crazy. That's why the whole country's after us. We got pictures all over the place. Don't matter if you're making a hit or robbing a bank, you gotta shoot everything all to hell. Look, DJ, I'm not a snitch, huh? All I wanna do is leave. That's exactly what I'm gonna do.
Come on now, Joey.
Stay back, Rose.
That's the most ridiculous.
Get away!
Joe.
Get away!
Well, hell, if that's the way you want it, go jump.
Rose.
Harlan, there's what's left of a body in there. And we found this.
Billy?
Lord, this is me again speaking on behalf of us all who, even though we're not your best servants, do try to do the best that we can.
Billy Pike was her friend, Lord. And her brother.
We'd appreciate it if you would exercise your almighty patience and give him whatever break you saw fit. Now, Lord, we all know that old Billy was a wild and foolish buck, but he is also braver than Joshua. Well, earlier today, he saved a little boy's life, and we was kind of hoping maybe you'd let that count for something. Maybe you could cut him a little slack or give him some time off due to good behavior. Amen.
Amen. Lord,
there's always a chance this could maybe be one of your miracles. Billy Pike is alive out there somewhere. Of course, if this isn't William, you do your best for whoever it is. Thank you.
Amen.
You killed my brother. This DJ Ballard's gonna die. Now, he'll cut a wide and bloody path. His kind always does. So we're gonna have to waste a couple of days before we track him so that we can arm ourselves.
Harlan, we don't know for absolute sure that Billy's dead.
John. No more discussion.
Feel bad, Horse. In a week or two, you'll be hitting everything you shoot at.
The problem is, we don't have a week or two.
Mr. Finch, did you remember to bring those other weapons I talked about? You know, something a little more old-fashioned, for instance?
And a sight slower.
And not so damned ugly.
Tough enough to get the job done.
Here's all I had in stock, fellas. They're older and slower, prettier. Tougher. They're antiques, boys. I mean, they're real antiques.
Mister, that's what we're talking about.
Now, them are pretty. Now, Billy, he would have liked this one.
Let me see that Navy coat.
Yeah, let me take a look at that lightning there.
With his gear, if you'll cover for us as a deputy.
Kind of lawman to lawman, huh?
Something like that. Mr. Finch, if you'll just follow us right down to the house, we can settle up down there. And...
the boys are not going anywhere. Not right now, you have my word on it.
These are arrest warrants, John, for Billy Ice and Wolf.
Yeah, they ain't changed much since my day.
What do you mean, your day?
I was associated with law enforcement, Megan. Long ways back.
Well, then you should know better, John. I mean, they escaped with DJ Ballard from the state correction work crew.
They're innocent. Ballard's not.
They are wanted men.
Well, I certainly know that, man.
Good Godfrey, John, this is serious. I had to convince my boss not to send more men out here. And then here y'all are, buying guns and shooting honeydews to hell and gone. A guard was wounded in the escape. He died this morning. There is also serious speculation that the men who helped Billy and the others escape on horseback, John, that those men are also part of Ballard's group and just as responsible.
That's not true.
I know they are your friends, but give it up, John.
Give it up? Maggie? Once upon a long time ago, down there, where the grasslands meet the hills, a small raiding party of Eastern Comanches got themselves surrounded and cut off. Instead of giving it up, they decided to fight. Stand the ground. The Texans outmanned them, outgunned them. But they sung the death chant, and they went down to the last brave. I understand now why they were dying. I understand now what they was dying for. Freedom, Maggie. Don't ever let anyone take that away from you. No matter what. Neither freedom nor your good name. That's what Ballard did to us. That's why we won't give it up.
Revenge.
Justice.
Where's Billy?
We don't know for certain. Where's Ballard?
Good God, John, you're going after Ballard?
Yes, Maggie. If you'll allow us.
Not a chance, John. You are all under...
Deputy Randall.
Don't draw.
Please, ma'am.
Ma'am?
Well, John, so much for lawman to lawman.
It's not your fault, Maggie. I mean, you know, there were four of us. There's nothing to be ashamed of.
Deputy Randall.
My sincerest apologies, ma'am.
I should have come out here with a SWAT team. Never talked at all.
Ma'am.
I should have just come out here, arrested all you courtly gentlemen, and thrown you in the slam.
Yes, ma'am. Maybe that would have been better.
Let the police handle this, John. Ballard and the others are killers, and if you do catch up with
them... Maggie, don't worry. Me and these boys have had a pretty fair amount of experience in that area. Ballard will swing, one way or another.
We'll whittle him down to size.
Force him to atone for his many transgressions.
But we will have have him weep some first.
Who are you?
Outlaws. Outlaws who've seen the light. Adios, Maggie.
We'll head for the New Mexico border.
Where Ballard jumped the roadblock.
That's right.
He won't get far.
Let's hope not.
So let's do it.
Amen.
Slow and easy.
All the way.
To the hilt.
Amen.
Amen.
Adios.
Whoop. Didn't see nothing worth mentioning.
All right. One more time.
Darling, give it a rest.
Give yourself a rest.
Ballard went through the roadblock here at Farwell, Texas. Went then across the New Mexico line here. Now, them New Mexican lawmen, they have their roadblock here and here. There's only one road in or out.
That means Ballard was running aground and he's holed up between Clovis, New Mexico, and right where we are now. That's the White River, south of...
Damn it.
Arlen's.
We've been over that. We've been over that. With a fine-tooth comb. All of it.
Arlen, why don't you calm down and have yourself some coffee?
I kind of like it here. Like freedom.
I like the smells, the taste. Kind of reminds me of a woman who gave me this Dawson.
I'm just a poor wayfaring stranger traveling through this world of woe, but there's no sickness, no toil nor danger in that bright world to which I go. I'm going there to see my father. I'm going there no more to roam.
Yes, going over Jordan. I'm just a going over home.
I knew it.
About time you boys got here.
Billy?
What the hot burning damn took you so long, Harlan?
What'd you do that for?
Why didn't you use one of them telephones and call me?
Well, I tried. You know, those ones by the side of the road like little outhouses?
Yeah.
I couldn't read the damn directions. And it was hard enough staying on Ballard's trail as it was.
Fair.
Ballard and the others boarded up back there. I've been watching them and waiting.
No sleep, no food.
I was afraid he might leave before you boys got here. I didn't think to see you on this, Sheriff.
John's the only one that had the true faith. He's the only one that really believed you was alive.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How come?
Well, you're way too ornery to die, Billy. Not yet, anyway.
You jokers bring me any clothes?
No.
bought this to replace the one you lost, will you?
Naked without it.
Use my extra.
You left yours on a sad little grave outside of Austin.
Well, that wasn't me.
Well, we thought it was you. Me and John even said some real nice sentiments over you.
Sorry to have caused you grief, Arlen. And I'd be just proud as hell to wear your extra. Anytime.
How far back did you say Ballard was holed up?
Just a couple miles as the crow flies. We should be there by first light.
Listen close, lady. I'm getting real tired of being polite.
Come on, man. Where was Ballard heading when he left here?
Go jump.
Sooner or later, Miss Rose, you are going to tell us what we need to know.
Just leave her alone, Harlan. Oh, this is just like you two ganging up on a body, hitting them from both sides.
Well, what would you prefer, Romeo? We could do a little courting, maybe a bunch of flowers, some candy.
Billy, it's not your fault Ballard got away. Now, she's the only one who can tell us. Tell us what we got to know.
And we ain't got time for any more niceties.
She did put a bullet in Brother Wolf.
Girl just creased me, that's all. What's all this talk about no more niceties, Harlan? Good Lord, you're getting to sound like everybody else in this faith-starved world. Justifying doing wrong because everybody else is doing wrong.
Say, ma'am, you like a little drink or something? Maybe a bite to eat?
No one's ever done that before.
Done what?
Stood up for me.
Ballard did that to you, Rose, didn't he?
So where'd you get yours?
I guess you could say Ballard, same as yours.
I know what you're thinking. We had our good times, too, you know? Maybe not a lot of good times, but I never did expect too much from DJ anyway. I saved his life, you know? I saved his life. And then last night, he gets real strange, and then he hit me. And he just kept on hitting me. You wouldn't do that, would you?
Yeah.
But What'll happen to me if I tell you?
Nothing's gonna happen to you.
They're flying to Los Angeles. DJ has a deal working to sell the money from the Denver job.
Sell the money?
Yeah. You know, the recorded serial numbers on all the bills. Hot money.
Sure. Hot money.
Yeah. Then they're leaving the country. Brazil or South America.
Where in Los Angeles is he going to meet these other people?
Give me a piece of paper, I'll draw you a map.
Hey, ma'am.
Never saw that side of your coin before, kid.
Handle the situation. Will you listen to that girl? You know how your pa was my best friend, and you know how he gave his life. I thought he was gone, but he isn't. Thank you, Bill.
Yeah, well, if you think that pretty speech changes anything between us, Grail, you couldn't be more mistaken.
Well, I didn't think that for a minute, Billy. Didn't think that for a minute. Hairier than when we rode the lightning. But it's a wonderment, isn't it?
I'll take the lightning any day. When they went into the firmament, I heard the noise of their wings like the noise of the great waters.
God, Harland. I wish my gun weren't packed away in the baggage compartment.
Could your gun do you now, Billy?
If I had my gun, I could shoot myself. Or this damn sardine can falls down.
DJ, you stay here until I call you. And he's shooting, come quick.
Hell, Luther. By this time tomorrow, we'll be sitting in Rio with a margarita in one hand and a senorita in the other.
Don't cut your senoritas yet, man.
Pass missed.
About time.
Diaz is with him.
Hey, DJ! What's it doing, Chico? How you doing, man?
Jesus, Ramon, you Cuban jerk.
Long time, mi amigo. Long time. Give me a hug, Gil. Come on. Come on.
Hey, DJ, man, you're becoming well known. A regular Juan Dillinger.
Me? Whose picture do we see in the Miami post office, huh? Luther, tell them, man, whose picture we saw.
Mr. Ramon Arroyo's.
Me? The one and only?
Two cars that way.
Yep. We may or may not come out of this in one piece, but I gotta say, it's been a privilege to ride with you boys again.
Likewise, John. But I wouldn't worry about it. We're dead men already.
So, let's do it.
Hey, man. Slow and easy.
All the way.
To the hilt.
talking about? Are you crazy or what?
The three of them are in the slam with you, man. And that kid, remember the one we blew up the road? It's them, and there's two guys with them. It's the Cowboys, man.
What's going on, DJ? This is beginning to make me nervous.
Rip-off artists. They tried to jump us once before.
Right, they've been dogging us. They must have picked up on the kind of money we got here.
What are they, cops?
Three of them went to prison with me. Some hick jail in Texas. Cowboys, huh? Don't worry, we got eight. They got five, no problem, right?
Me a good watch, that's all.
This is not so easy.
I got you! Stay where you are, though!
Oh! Oh! Yeah, got it, boys!
Come on, let's join the party.
We'll flank them, DJ.
I count five guns left.
Odds are back in our favor.
These boys should take their time and aim straighter.
Obliged if they don't, thank you.
If they got any sense, they should be working their way alongside us. Cowboys want to show them? Huh? Come on!
Over here.
Who's next? Come on, who's next?
Here. Meet your maker with a smile, Ballard.
My turn, Mr. Ballard.
Pick it up and use it, you piece of dirt.
Didn't put up much of a fight.
Well, see if we can find you a better one. Next time.
I want to thank you
for covering me back there.
Hellfire Grail. It only made the whole play that much more interesting.
It's going to be real interesting when the police arrive.
That's the Lord's truth.
Hey, but wait a minute now. This time we're all on the side of law and order. Right, Sheriff?
Right, Bill.
That's an absolute fact.
The fallen have become righteous.
When asked about their background, John Grail replied that he and his partners were hit by lightning back in 1899 and rode the bolt to the present time.
Oh, sure.
And so, Mr. Grail continued, our backgrounds wouldn't be of much interest to you fellas nowadays. Good Godfrey, wouldn't that be a strange thing?
Come on, it's a gag or a joke. Maybe they just like the privacy.
Smart is what it is. Mm-hmm. You can just wait. Them good old boys are going to be up to their ears in clients for too long.
Yeah, they're the craziest jobs in the book.
Not so for that.